Welcome back to KANG TV News. I'm Addison.
And I'm Charlotte. We are taking over this week's newscast and we are in the Aux Gym.
KSPN's Marlena and Aida will have a sports report in a couple of minutes. First off, an update on the England trip this summer with Ms. Gamache and Ms. Cathal.
Listen up, because there's a few major changes. First off, they have added stops in Ireland and Scotland, as well as just England. And secondly, the trip has been extended from 9 days to 10.
The trip will still be at the beginning of summer break. The last day for manual payments is February 15th, so if you're interested, you need to register soon. Scan the QR code on the screen or contact Ms. Gamache or Ms. Cathal.
What's up, Kangs? I'm here on location with Mr. Joss and Miss Bell, here to talk to you about some news about the nutrition times on this Wednesday. Miss Bell?
All right, hey Kangs. So I went and talked with student leadership about nutrition break. We currently have a 15-minute nutrition break and it is packed. So if you've been in the Commons, you can see it's standing room only. Even the wings are crowded. It's just a lot of people out for about 15, 20 minutes. And we want to help you make that work for you. So as it's been, we have been keeping kids on campus in the building. No soccer, no fun at all. And now we are ready to loosen that up based on student feedback and allow you to have the freedom to go out to a vehicle and get something to eat or drink, go for a walk on campus, go out and play soccer, as some of you love to do, go maybe make a Starbucks run. If you can get back in time, it's a really short amount of time, but we don't want to guard the doors and keep you inside. You have the privilege and responsibility of leaving campus during lunch. We want to open it up and allow you the responsibility to move around a little bit more at nutrition break. So. Mr. Joss is going to talk to you a little bit about what that means for you in terms of getting back to class on time.
Thank you, Ms. Bell. Hi, Kangs. Yes, what Ms. Bell was said is right on the nose. If you leave campus anytime, you got to be back for your next class on time. Remember, you get 7 free tardies before consequences kick in, and those consequences can be lunch detention or after school detention. And I don't want to do it, and I know you don't want to do it. So get to class on time.
Dozens of LDUP students are getting ready to compete at DECA's state competition in a couple of weeks.
Let's take a look at those amazing KANGs who are representing us.
DECA's state competition is February 29th through March 2nd, 2024 in Bellevue.
Registration for next year's classes begins today at 3:30 when the Skyward portal opens. It will stay open until next Friday, February 9th at midnight. You can request courses or change those course requests. Head over to LDUP's website for a link to step-by-step instructions for registration. And if you have any questions, feel free to talk to your counselor or your teachers.
Attention all boys interested trying out in soccer this spring. Tryouts will be held on Monday, February 26th.
Please make sure you complete all of the information needed on final forms, which includes your most recent physical. If you are not cleared on final forms, you will not be able to try out. You can find more information at lakewashingtonsoccer.com.
There will be a voluntary workout today from 3:45 to 5:15. If you want to take part, make sure you have proper shoes and shin guards. If you have any questions, please see Coach Adamick in room 167 or email him.
Let's check in with Aida and Marlena for more on KANG Sports.
What's up, KANGs? Welcome back to this week's KSPN. I'm Aida.
And I'm Marlena. Stay tuned for this week's sports report. It's a hefty one.
First off, huge congratulations to our boys varsity basketball team winning 65-45 against Hazen.
And girls basketball who crushed Bellevue 53-43.
Take a look at our girls' spirit and teamwork on the court. Behind the scenes, KSB and Addison mic'd up our players during training.
You want to say anything?
Hey guys, girls basketball!
I'm
You just went on my foot. Yeah, I just got my foot stepped on, Dad. We're in blue.
I have high close, I have AC.
It's because she always falls. Every practice, every game, she's taking tumbles, always falling.
Amazing work. Thank you, Addison and the girls' varsity team. Girls have their first playoff game this Monday at home.
Be sure to come and support and cheer on our girls.
Speaking of cheer, our team competes at state this weekend at 1:55 at Battleground High School. Congrats, cheer.
Also, come support our fantastic dance team at Eastlake tomorrow at their competition on 12 p.m. Good luck, dancers. Our boys' swim team had their senior night against Redmond.
And guess what?
What?
It went amazing! They will be competing in their first postseason meet, KingCo, today and tomorrow. Go KANG swimmers!
Thanks for tuning in to this week's KSPN. I'm Aida.
And I'm Marlena.
And this is KSPN
out!
Here are a couple of club announcements. Robotics Club is holding a fundraiser at Mod Pizza in Totem Lake on February 6th. Mention code PURPLE at the register.
Next week, during both lunches, head over to the KANG closet to check out some gently used donated clothes for low, low prices. You will also be supporting our very own ASB with your shopping.
Anime Club also welcomes you to join them in the room 332 on Mondays after school.
And Latino Club invites you to their family night tonight at 6:30 in the One West Pod.
The Contemporary Media Analysis Club, also known as Film Club, is looking for a musician to compose music for their film projects.
If you're interested or just want more information, email Ms. Ring at the address on your screen. They meet Mondays from 7:45 to 8:15 a.m. in room 330. That's it for this week's newscast. As always, I'm Addison.
And I'm Charlotte. Have a great weekend. And
go KANGs!